And then verse 49. But Jesus' friends, including the women who followed him from Galilee, stood at a distance watching. Jesus' friends, those who appreciated him. And I wonder today whether you are friendly with Jesus but at a distance. He's a good model. He espouses good values. And you're friends with him. You don't dislike Jesus, but you're at a distance. And by your life, you actually say to him, Jesus, keep your distance, because if I get close to you, my life will have to change. I want you to give me space, Jesus. And if you say that to him, he will do that. But his preference is that you come close. He wants to be in relationship with you. The intimacy that Jesus had with the Father that was evident in the garden, crying out to God, he wants that same intimacy with you. And he chose to count the cost in the garden. He chose to count the cost before the high priest, before the governor. And he chose to die. But what will we choose this Good Friday? You see, he asks us to choose him. And he doesn't want friendship at a distance, but up close and personal. And it involves surrender. It involves us coming close to him. It involves us coming to the foot of the cross. And saying, I surrender to you, Jesus. I acknowledge that what you did on the cross was for me. And I invite you to be the CEO of my life. And if we do that, God places his Spirit within our spirits. And we are born anew. Sarah's going to sing to us a solo at the foot of the cross. Throughout this service, this place of prayer at the front is always open. There's something powerful about physically responding to God. Because you can sit in your seat and say, yes, I want to make this step, but there's something about getting up from where you are and doing something that cements it in your mind and in your body and in your spirit. And if you need to come, you come. Jesus wants relationship with you up close and personal, not friendship